Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord, saints. Big Zion Missionary Baptist Church, located at 521 West 65th Street, where Pastor Antonio M. Grafton is the leader. Look, they are celebrating 102nd year anniversary. I need you to enjoy this program already in progress. You can Ustream it, you can YouTube it, and don't forget, Channel 36, CAN TV. Go to that dial and look us up. God bless you in Jesus' name. This is Reverend Sean David Coleman, your producer. I love you.
Church. nor success. The Lord does. All of our help comes from. Now I'm almost finished. Pastor Grafton. And my good sister here. Bless your heart. I didn't know preachers could look that good. Sometimes it's a blessing even being in the mess. Just how you look at things. And I'd rather be in the mess, saved. Than outside, unsaved. It's really how you look at it. So you learn to count your blessings. That's a blessing. I mean that your candle is still lit.
Yes, Lord.
I know some congregations didn't make it a year. The light went out and it was over. The fact that you are still here suggests that the Lord is still with you. And so I want you to take that and be encouraged and know that God has something greater in store for you. Now the key to it is working together. Because what I do know, after being in this business for a while, everybody in church usually work.
All right.
Everybody work. But the problem comes in because we don't work together. Sometimes we work against. One is going off that way. That way. And the Lord let things be done decent and in order. Y'all alright? I don't know if this is one of those quiet Sundays, but at Pioneer I have at least one quiet Sunday a month. And those are my best Sundays. Because we just chat. I'll ask them a couple of questions. They answer. They ask me a couple of questions, you know, with the expression. And I answer. And then by the time I say, well, I gotta let it go, they tell me, no, keep going. But those other Sundays when I'm flying, riding the surf, they give each other a high five. And just so I get through, they say, whew. this is a quiet Sunday. I'm just talking. But I do want to share with you, and let me acknowledge your thing according to the scriptures.
Amen.
Is that your thing?
Amen.
That's a great thing.
Great.
Amen.
Because if you're not going according to the scriptures, you're not going to be in order.
That's right.
Amen. Everything you do ought to be according. According to the scriptures. The scriptures define what we are supposed to be like. And what we are not supposed to be like. Be ye holy. And be not conformed to this world. Y'all want to shout?
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Now this is something you can shout on. Because this will give you some substance. Some solace. So that when you leave from Big Zion and go back down to where you live and have to deal with the people with real issues, you now have been equipped to go and stand and look at that enemy and say, you thought you had me. And it doesn't matter what kind of weapon they throw on you, because when you go according to the scriptures, you understand that no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper.
Yes.
Doesn't matter what you go through, doesn't matter. We have to understand, because of what Adam and Eve did, we now have seasons. There are seasons in our lives.
Amen.
My wife, who's a native of Natchez, Mississippi, I think they had maybe one or two seasons. But when she migrated to the north on her hands and knees looking for me, she found four seasons. Summer, fall, winter, and spring. And because she hangs out with me, them seasons can pop in and out unnoticed.
Yes.
Ain't no such thing her crying and talking about, but it's July. But if it's a season of winter in July, she's got to roll with the punches.
Yes.
And so God equips his church
so
that they can deal with the seasons. Amen. We all love carnivals. We love the good times. We're so good, we just reminisce all the time. I remember when. Anybody here remember when?
Yeah.
Well, listen, when is gone.
Yeah.
You need to understand the season that you're in.
Yeah.
And so I just want to quickly, in the last 5 minutes or 6 minutes that I have left, I want to ask you to turn in your Bible, because there's a passage there that I want to lift up on your 102nd year anniversary.
Mm-hmm.
Turn with me to the book of Nehemiah. Nehemiah chapter 6. Nehemiah chapter 6. And those first few verses, you're going to run into these words. And I'm reading from the New King James Version. Nehemiah chapter 6, verses 1, 2, and 3. Now it happened when Sanballat, Tobiah, Geshem, the Arab, and the rest of our enemies heard that Big Zion was still in business.
Oh, yes, sir.
That there were no bricks left in it, though at that time the work had not been completed. We're in Nehemiah chapter 6.
It's recorded.
I had not hung the doors in the gate that Sanballat and Geshem sent to me, saying, come, let us meet together among the villages in the plain of Ono. Someone say, oh no.
Oh no.
That's what you need to tell that enemy every once in a while. Oh no.
Oh no.
but they sought or thought to do me harm. So I sent messengers to them saying, I am doing a great work so that I cannot come down. Why should the work cease while I leave it and come down to you? Amen. Big Zion, stay on the wall.
Amen.
I bless you. Stay on the wall. Stay on the wall. Stay on the wall. Stay on the wall. That's where the work is. Nehemiah is the writer of this text. I should share with you that Nehemiah was not a preacher. Nehemiah was a layman. But what Nehemiah had to his advantage is he knew God.
Yes.
And he had such a love for God, he was willing to work not only with God, but work for God. Now, I'm saying what I'm saying, and I pray that you just kind of grab it and catch it, because if you wait on a certain point, you will have missed what I'm really trying to tell you. Nehemiah, he's a court official,
yes.
So he understands politics.
Mm-hmm.
How many of you know that you got to, it helps you know the Lord, and it also helps in no season.
Yeah.
He was one of a high-ranking officer upon the Artaxerxes, king, who was king at this time of Persia. And Nehemiah sat at the royal table in the presence of the king, and he was the first Sunday communion man for the king. He would sample the cup.
Yes.
I know Big Zion knows nothing about sampling the cup. Yeah, I know you all don't drink anything other than Christian brothers. No, right, it's just champagne, okay. Nehemiah was in a position that he was sensitive to the moving of God.
Yes.
I ask you, I'm going to ask you some questions. In 102 years of existence, who in Big Zion is sensitive to the Lord? Who senses the movement of God to this degree that you say, whatever you want me to do, I'm going to do it. Whatever you want me to say, I'm going to say. Wherever he wants me to go, I'm going to go. Doesn't matter who's against me. It doesn't matter who fights me on it. I'm going to do the bidding for the Lord.
Amen.
Nehemiah was that kind of person who had a solid commitment to not only the Lord, but to the work of God. He heard that things in Jerusalem worked well. The wall was coming down. The wall had deteriorated over time. You do know that over time. Well, how many of you know time has a way?
Yes.
Is there anybody here like it used to be? You keep having birthdays, and you keep eating Wonder Bread. You be down at the bottom of the steps looking up from step wondering. You inhale, you exhale, you grab the rail, and there's a rail, and you pull yourself up. You remember how you used to just run up steps, two skip two steps at a time? Run down the steps. Some of you even slid on the banister. Woo! Now I'm at the top of the steps, terrified. Paranoid, oh God. You look at home, there's an ambulance around there just in case. Time can rob you. Anyone remember how sharp their minds used to be? I mean, quick. You pick up on things and now you become a hop. Say what? Say it one more time. Remember how good you, how well you, your vision was? I mean, probably most of y'all, when you first got a pair of glasses, it was just a fashion statement. And now, honey, you need those things. Matter of fact, you had a couple of pairs. One pair to see with, one pair to read with, one pair to help you find other pairs. And then everybody, most of the time, you keep having birthday, you have an invisible pair. Yeah. Those are the ones you have on that you're looking for. Remember how strong your hair used to be? I can just take that comb through it. Lord, help me now. Now it's just easy to throw a hat on. Put a hat on. I know I hit a bad note when I did that. But I don't see no bad hair dudes today. Y'all look good.
Always know how the way was going to be made, but God
win.
Yes, we can.
And it is my duty to just remind you that God has not changed.
All right.
No, sir. No, sir.
You know how wise God is? Sometimes God cleans out in order to stock.
Yes. All right.
We just had a rummage sale at the church, and a lot of people got rid of some of the rummage. But what I noticed, and don't tell the members of Pioneer, that they start buying up the stuff. Now they're supposed to be selling it, get rid of it, and they start buying it up among themselves. But what God did, he said, so that you all don't have to buy it all, he sent the community in. Yeah. And it was such an overwhelming flow of people coming in, making purchases. I'm telling you, God has a way of making ways out of no way.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
God so fixed it with Nehemiah that the kings and lumber yards said, listen, we got some stuff we can give to you. We hear your passion. We feel the pride you have in the ministry that's assigned to your hands. Mm-hmm. My brothers and sisters, I think this is Inglewood, right?
Yes.
They need to feel your pride.
Amen. Amen.
I don't think you need to wait for Rainbow Push just to tell you you are somebody. Am I with a witness here?
Yes.
God knows where you are, and God knows the plans and the thoughts he has for you. Nehemiah was focused, and so now he goes to Jerusalem, and he has some workers working with him. They start to work. And Nehemiah said, listen, let's have a quick prayer meeting. He has prayer and he gives some instructions. That's what church service is about. It's about prayer and instructions. It's about prayer and instructions. It's about prayer and instruction. You ought to come here praying. You ought to pray after you get here. And then while you're here, you ought to pray some more so that when you get the instructions, it's clear. It's about prayer and instruction. Somebody gonna catch this in a moment here. And so Nehemiah shares with his workers that I need you all, I need both hands in operation. One hand will have a tool.
Yes.
And the other hand will have a little something. Because Pookie and Ray Ray and Shanae are going to show up. And they're not going to show up for the same purpose and reason that you're in business.
Yes.
Every now and then they're going to show up here. And they ain't going to show up for the purpose of worship. And you're going to need to be clear in hearing the instructions that comes only after you have done what? Pray. And you'll need to be clear. Nehemiah said, listen, you're going to use that tool to work with, and you're going to use that something else to make sure the enemies remain at bay.
Yes, sir.
And so they're working. But as will always happen, when you're really in a good groove, when you really got a consistent work going on, that's when the enemies show up.
Amen.
Yes, sir. Here come these three fellas who come in. People most often say just three. It wasn't just three. Mm-hmm. Only three of them were named.
Amen.
You go back and check the text for me. But it's right there. Only three of them were named. Sanballat, Geshem, right?
Mm-hmm.
Who was the other guy?
Tobiah.
Can I suggest to you in a real friendly way that we all have those same fellas?
Yes.
Who will show up When you're at work, they will show up when you have command, when you made up in your mind that I'm going to simply do what the Lord wants me to do. And when they show up, they never want to show up at work. They won't stop the work. They won't talk about it. Let's just talk. We need to have a business meeting. I get so sick of business meetings. Because most often they're not about the business of the church. Don't come with calculators. How much tape are we on for?
All right.
I had that question asked over and over, and I finally got an answer from the Lord. I said, brother, if you can tell me how much you put in the building for me. And that was the last year that brother asked what we brought in the building. Amen. The work of the church is about missions.
Yes.
It's about fortifying the wall so that when the enemy comes, at best, the enemy has to knock. Can I suggest to you that the enemy should not have an easy access into the Big Zion?
Amen.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Preach, man. Preach, man. You're doing good.
Yes, sir.
The enemy, if the enemy can just walk through the door and stake his claim anywhere, somebody not pray.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
You heard that acronym PUSH. P-U-S-H, push, pray until something happens.
Yes, sir.
That's right, amen.
The church has to always be in prayer.
Amen.
Oh. Yes. Matter of fact, Jesus said, man ought to always pray and not faint. There ain't no time to fall out. Ain't no time to, oh, what we gonna do? This is a time when the church should rise up and say, we're going to be mighty in God. Do you know with just one person and God, that's the majority?
Yes,
and if you have the majority of folk and don't have God, you all will lose the team.
Well, yeah.
This is the struggle that not only Big Zion, but Pioneer and any church runs into. And that is building the wall. Enemies will come. They will come. They want to stop you from the work. But what I appreciate is Nehemiah stands. He said, listen, we're doing good work. There's 3 points I see right there. I'm going to leave you alone. I promise you. But there's 3 points I see right here. When it comes, when they come, listen, verse 3. So I sent messengers to them saying, now they sent word to Nehemiah saying, come down and talk. Come down, let's be grabbing, come on down. If he's the pastor, can I suggest this? Let him pastor.
Amen.
If he is the pastor, let him pastor. Because he has so much that he has to deal with. Fighting against sin and Satan, but the keeper of the wall. And if the enemy is allowed to come in and run rampant, then when it does, it disrupts the instructions that Big Zion ought to be getting.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
I try not to even tell churches to say amen because church is supposed to know the truth.
Amen.
And the church here, says Katie, when they hear the truth, they just say what?
Amen.
That we do at church. I know we're modern, we got for everything, but a fool can get up and get a lot more food too. So there has to be a distinction in how we do church.
Amen.
Now y'all invite me back. But I told you already up front, this is one of those talk Sundays.
Amen.
Y'all might be talking to you. Now, he can hoop and sing. I ain't doing all that. I'll make some sense today.
Yes.
Of what I'm saying. And I pray that you'll receive it. They come to Nehemiah and they want him to come down. They want him to stop the work. I told you that Nehemiah was sensitive to God.
Yes.
And brothers and sisters, when you're sensitive to God, sometimes God will send you in a different direction. Sometimes God will have you doing some things that will mystify people who think you ought to be doing it a different way. But what I appreciate about Nehemiah is he said, listen, I know what they said. I know they want to meet with me. But go and tell them. Here it is, right there, verse 3. Go and tell them, number one, I'm doing a great work.
All right.
I'm doing a great work. It doesn't matter what your evaluation of it is. Doesn't matter what you think or how you feel. Working for God, I'm doing a great work. Mm-hmm. And how do you know leading a congregation is not easy? Anybody raise any children?
Yeah.
How easy was that? Now imagine a whole church full of your children. All those personalities. Looks
fruit.
You know, are you listening to me? Yeah. Don't talk to me with that disrespectful term. You better straighten up. Slamming doors. Same stuff happened in the church. And we grow. Come on, talk to me, y'all. Well, you know. I'm old enough to be your mama twice. But the terms of the contract is, I'm your shepherd.
All right. Amen.
So you can be as old as you want to be.
That's right.
But I'm your shepherd.
Right.
And if I'm your shepherd, that makes you my sheep.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Preach, man. You know you preach. You preach better than they say an amen. He says, I'm doing a great work. This work that Nehemiah is doing was not something that he just made up in his mind. Listen, when you delight yourself in the Lord, he gives you the desires of your heart. But you need to understand those desires of your heart are not your desires. It's what he really wants you to do. And he lays it in your spirit and you start saying, I think I'm going to do this.
All right.
He lays it there. And that's why you can be successful. Because when whatever God gives you to do, if you do it, you'll always be successful.
All right.
Nehemiah didn't let them belittle him. They criticized him. They talked about if a fox walk on the wall, it will come down.
Right.
Nehemiah says, go tell them.
Yes.
But Pastor, every now and then you have to tell those who bring you those messages. Go back and tell them.
All right.
I know this is not past the anniversary, but I see several things leaping up from this text. The second thing that Nehemiah says is, I cannot come down. The enemy can't deal with you at a high altitude. I mean, color folks can't deal with you at an altitude. They want to get you down.
Right.
That's why you don't give the authority to get you angry.
Amen.
You get angry, you almost, you do anything. Some of you might have said something in anger. And then wishing that you can take it back, but it's gone. You don't give up your power and authority. You don't give up your integrity because somebody wants to act like they don't know no better. Isn't that what they call you? Growing up, you know, sticks and stones may break my bones, but names would never harm me. And all they had to do was say to me, "Your mama." And honey, it was over. Your mama's a man. She playing the man. She jumped out the window with Superman. Oh, it was on. Now I got suspended. Mother had to come to school only to find out that my mama wasn't a man. She didn't play the man. She didn't jump out the window with Superman. So I had to grow up. And I had to quit coming down because people want me to come down. Everybody's not happy when you do when you're prospering. Everybody's not happy with you when you're doing well. Everyone is not happy with you when the flow of God is upon you. As a matter of fact, there are a lot of people who's jealous of you. Because they think you got more than what you actually have. But when you're anchored in God, you learn how to have a spirit of whatever my rock fowl has taught me to say, it's well with my soul. You gotta know, you gotta learn how to be alright with where God bless you. You gotta learn how to be content with what God gives you to work with. You don't think he said that we had more this. No, use what you got. Watch to see your flesh. Yes, Lord. One more thing in there. There's one more thing in there that he questions or challenges when he asks, when he says, "I cannot come down." He asks this question: why should the work cease while I leave it and go down? Go down. Go down to you. Why should I leave my lofty position and go down to you? Why should I give up the glory of God to go down to you and be miserable? Why should I leave the high mountain and come down just to have a fist fight? Why should I stop praising God and come down to you just so I can have cursing lessons?
All right.
Yes, sir. Nehemiah was a wise man.
Yes.
Last 2 minutes I have, I wonder how many wise Nehemiahs after 200 years, after 102 years, are hanging around Big Zion.
All right.
You don't give up your place. You don't give up your spot. You don't give up your position to go down.
That's right, man.
We're moving up the King's Highway. And sometimes, like Gideon, God gotta knock the size down in order for you to win the war. So who can the Lord defend you on? Can I tell you the end of the story? The wall got built. Skeptics were still out there, still doing what they were doing. I don't see how they're going to do it. I don't see how they're going to make it. Pioneer is a witness of what God can do. Pioneer has a handful of folks. Praise the Lord. But through God, Pioneer has been able to do some mighty things. People have wondered and looked and speculated and investigated and dug and asked around town, how did they get to where they are?
Come on.
How do they do what they do? When we can count the members on our fingers and toes.
All right.
What they missed was who's blessing us.
Yes.
What they missed was who we're working for.
That's it.
What they missed were a few little meaningless passages like, if God is for you, He's more than the world against you. They miss God is our refuge and our strength. Stay on the wall. Say what God says about you. A preacher. Y'all in the suburbs. Well, it don't take you long to realize the ghetto is everywhere. But when God is working on your behalf,
yes,
you don't have to come down.
Yeah.
One more fellow who was up on the wall, and they tried to get him to come down. Probably somewhere around Jerusalem, too. Conversation went like this. Why don't you save me and save yourself? There were some more enemies down there. Tell him, come on down. But he wouldn't come down. I hear Jesus said, why should I come down to your level?
Yes, sir.
And the work sees it. If I come down, Big Sign and Pioneer will not be in business.
Well, well.
If I come down, somebody who's lost in sin will never find a savior.
Yes, sir.
And so he stayed on the wall.
Yes, all right. Yes, he did.
And he stayed there until it was time for them to take him down.
Yeah.
They took him down and put him in a borrowed tomb.
Yeah.
We don't close up shop. This thing is all over.
Yeah.
Old Rascal pulled out one of these. We got him. We got him, yeah. Honey, he thought he was something big. We got him.
Yeah.
Hold on. I got one coming. Hold on. Yeah, child. I know we got. I'm telling you, we got it. Yeah. Joe Four Horse, we got him. Honey, he's deader than a doornail. You know that's right. It was a matter of time. Hold on. Look, I gotta call you back. I gotta call you back. This is my boo. Hold on. Hey, babe. We finally won. He gave up the ghost. He died. And they done sealed the tomb.
Really?
some crazy glue and Gorilla Tape. Honey, that man is coming out of there. He's gone. Child, you may go get some sleep. Tomorrow we're gonna party. He gone. Mary's baby. You know. Yeah, he dead. Ezekiel's will. He dead. Hang up. I'm just gonna text him. I'm gonna send out a blast.
Baptism, once again.
for your membership. Won't you come?
Come on, friends, they even tell us.